That flag?
There you go.
Hey, we're on. Andy, this might be the highest vantage point we've ever seen. We look like we're at the Oakland Coliseum out here getting ready for our second playoff game here in for Reading. Reading took care of Methuen last week in big fashion, really rolled those guys. But this is going to be another story tonight because this Lawrence team is very good by all accounts. A team that took care of Acton-Boxborough. We saw those guys. They were very good.
Yes, they were.
So we beat Acton-Boxborough by a point. Lawrence beats them by a point. The feedback we have from the scouting team is they got only about 18 kids here. And you'll see, I think it may be number 21 down there, gets the ball almost all the time for these guys. Good little athletes, not a real big team. But I think they may be running into some big guys like Stephen Webb and Keith Richmond and Danny DeMari on defensively, who's got some speed going. I'm all pumped up right here, Andy. Can you tell it?
Yes, you can.
I'm pumped up because I can't
ready
even breathe.
Go.
I just ran up the stairs like Rocky here. And the and Redding's getting all fired up. And guess what? The rain stopped. It's perfect out here. So we're going to be coming back soon with the kickoff. The captains are just – this is about as close as we can get, by the way, with this vantage point across the side. So good luck me seeing any of these guys.
Yeah.
I'll be calling wrong numbers and names all day long. So I'm going to ask for your help on that one. But Dan DeMari, Troy Pollock, and Dan O'Connor about to walk out and take the toss, and we'll be back shortly. All right, here's the kickoff here, and Reading is going to be receiving here. Stephen Webb and Dante Barboza back deep. It's a squib kick. It doesn't go 10 yards, so that's got to be a penalty. And it's going to be a penalty. It's going to leave the Rockets with great field position. Goes
right
off the side
bat.
Of his foot. The Rockets going to take over. I think they tack on 5 more yards from there. I'm not sure, which should put him inside the 45-yard line. And it looks like we're going to start with you'll probably see a steady dose of number 24 is going to be our boy Lucas Fleming. So the Rockets going to start out here first and 10 from the 48. Yep. Here we go. It is Lucas with Sean Beckenhuis. No secrets early on with Bob Junta's offense. Steady dose of the big man. See if he can take it. Oh, Lucas gets caught from behind, but he does gain about 3 or 4 yards. Nice tackle right there. He stayed with him, but Lucas had a little bit of room for him. There is a flag. Let's see what they call it here. They call it an encroachment on Lawrence, so they're going to take it first and 5. So
Lawrence saw the big man with it and was trying to get in early.
They did. So Lucas almost had a little bit of running room behind him. Good job for number 32 coming across tackling him, but we're going to take this down over again. Here we go. It's going to be second down here. We have Lucas and Sean Beckenhuis, 2 split left. Right to Lucas, he goes left. He guys to go outside, but he gets strung out there. So good athletes here to string him out. I think Lucas wants to take that one a little bit more north to south.
Yeah.
He's a big guy, put his shoulder into somebody, see if he can drive him. So that's actually a pushback on first down, and it's gonna be, call it 2nd and 7. Okay, call it 2nd and now 8 here. Stephen Webb in the backfield now. Right there, follows Sean Beckenhuis. He cuts up. He gets some room. Steven's got some room ahead of him. Oh, the ball's on the ground. He fumbles the ball, and it looks like the Rockets have it. So Steven had a huge amount of room, and the ball goes on the ground, and I can't help but think sometimes that could be the weather out there. This is going to be slick, that field, even though it's turf.
It looks like
they did lose it. They're sending a whole new offense in here.
Looks like,
but it's going to be 3rd down coming up.
Looks
and,
like Dave Swanson might have jumped on that.
Wow, nice play. Nice play by Swanee. We'll come right back out here with 3rd and short. Yep. Here we go. Fortunate for Reading to get on that ball. We talked about these fumbles against good teams. Oh, it's over his head. Steven's got to run for his life. He's got guys all over him. Oh, and he pulls him down. So nice athletic move, number 21. He's their big star, what we heard. And he stops him. It's going to be 4th and 4. But look for the Rockets to go for it here.
Yep.
All right, big 4th down play here, and Troy Pollock comes in. No, it's actually going to be back to inside handoff to Dante Barboza, and he gets stacked up immediately for a loss. So that's a new-looking play there, but I tell you, Lawrence comes right through there, and they've had great push defensively, and they're going to turn the ball over on down. So let's see what that big Rocket defensive line can do with Lawrence's first time with the ball. Okay, like I said, a lot of good athletes here.
Good job.
Big defensive line. The handoff right up the middle, and he gets absolutely stacked up immediately, pulled down by a slew of guys. Doesn't want to go down easy, but Oki's in there, Keith Richmond's in there, and Fleming, and that's a short gain of about 2 yards. Going to be 2nd and 8 coming up. Okay, here we go. 2nd down, call it 8. defensive guys moving around here. They got three guys split out right. They like to throw the ball, they said. Got one guy in motion. It's a handoff. It's a fake handoff right up the middle, number 34, and it's a huge play. He puts his head down. Big hit right on top of number 11, or 41, Sean Beckenhues. But that's a first down, so nice little misdirection there. Inside handoff, and he takes it for a first, so good-looking play. Okay, first and 10 here from the Rocket 42-yard line. Nice-looking play right there. He's got a guy in motion. It's a handoff. It's going to be a reverse right here. Number 21 comes in. See if they can string him out. Dante does string him out. Can he catch him? And he does.
They did.
Beautiful play. Dante and Sean Beckenhues. That might have been number 11, Jeremy Roshway out there. Beautiful play. They do a reverse, and it tricks no one. And Rockets push him back for 5 yards. So big third down and long coming up. Or second and long, sorry. Okay, here we go. It's second and call at 12 here after the pushback by Barboza and Rosh. More traditional setup right here. Handoff right up the middle and gets pulled down immediately. Wow, great job right there. Let me see who grabbed it. Might have been number 41 was in there, Beckenhues. 54 was in there, Oki, on the playing the other side, and number 22, Damari. So there's another pushback, and it's going to be third and 15 coming up. All right, big split formation here. This is where they see these guys maybe throw the ball. They're not afraid to do it. In motion, it's a handoff number one. He does it again, and now it's a razzle-dazzle. He throws it underneath, and right there, there's the play. Stay on him. Okay, oh, boy. He doesn't make the first down, but number 15, Harrigan, was in there and had him snuffed out and couldn't take him down, and now we get a penalty in the play. Let's see what happens if it's going to come back. Sideline warning on the coaches, huh? That's an odd one. I don't know if that's an actual penalty, but it looks like it's going to be fourth down here. I don't know if they marched something off here, but we'll take a look.
That's
come back
first
in a sec.
Time for that one.
All right, it is a fourth down. First time you've seen a flag this ain't a sideline warning. This is a big play right here for the Rockets. They'd love to get it back. Traditional set here. Nice job getting back online right there. Danny Junta. They're trying to draw him off sides here. There's a handoff up the middle. Oh, he cuts back. He's got room. Nice shifty move right there. He's still on his feet. So, hey, he's a good player. That number 21 gets it all the time and rips off a big play down to the 20-yard line. So fourth down, the Rockets can't come up there. But I'll tell you, that was a nice run by 21, and he's the guy they give it to almost all the time, they say. So first and goal inside the red zone. Make that first and 10 inside the red zone. And Lawrence got a little bit of momentum right here. There's a pitch out there. Oh, it looks like a bunch of people moving there. They're going to move it back and make it first and 15. A little motion on Lawrence, and we're going to redo first down here. Call it first and 15 right now after the false start. This is a big spread defense right here. He's going to go back. He's going to try to throw it. He throws it underneath. Oh, it gets picked. Picked off right there.
Nice.
Great play. Gets pulled down. And good play by number 21 to do it because I don't know who that was. That was Barboza. He could have been gone. 43, Dante, I think, comes in and takes that thing. And they pick it off, so huge turnover right here.
Big, big play.
And that's exactly what we talked about earlier. These games are very, very tight, and you got to win the turnover battle. And if you do, things can go your way. Great play. Snuffed out the pass, going to the guy 21. They have Barboza, and they have Damari spying him all game, and the Rockets come firing right back out, first and 10. So let's see what they can come up with on the second series of downs here. Okay, first and 10 here for the Rockets. I think that's big Lucas Fleming in there behind Beckenhues. He follows Beckenhues. Big move. He spins. He's still on his feet. So nice drive of about 5 or 6. And that's the type of Lucas Fleming we like to see. You do that every day, it's going to be hard to stop him. So nice job spinning off. Lucas has done a much better job of holding on to the ball after having a little bit of, you know, he hasn't really run the ball this year. At the beginning of the year, he had some time carrying the ball out a little bit too far. And he's done a much better job of late. And so here we are with second and 4. Right back, he follows again. Oh, he gets met almost immediately. Still on his feet, drives it. Wow, first down for Lucas. One guy comes in, hits him, it means nothing. He spins off of it, takes it for 5 yards. I'm like, that's a tough guy to see coming at you. 155 pounds at 24. And Lawrence is getting a dose right now. And here's the thing about Lawrence, they get about 19 kids on the team. You start stringing these things out, these guys are going to be on the field all night long. And the Rockets can wear you down because they have numbers. Steven Webb in the shotgun right now behind Beckenhuis. Right there, he falls. Beckenhuis, he puts his head down. He drives it for about two. He gets tripped up. But nice job. You see Steven put two hands on the ball that time. He doesn't want to lose it again, and it's going to be second and eight. Okay, here we are. It's going to be second and about, maybe call it a long eight. We have Fleming back in there after getting a one-time breather. Lucas takes it. Nice job. He puts his head down, drives it for a few. They're trying. He spins around again, and he gets probably three or four right there. So it's going to be third and just about five upcoming. Go. It's third and there. Well, not a great spot right there. He was well over that 45-yard line, but mm-hmm. It looks like Redding's going to call timeout right now. I don't think Redding got a nice spot there, but then we're going to take a timeout and come back. Okay. It's the end of the first quarter, actually, so they let the thing run down. Rockets are on a big third down play here. Love to do something right here. I think that's Troy Pollock. And Troy's going to go back and throw, and he throws it underneath. He's got Webb. Webb comes. Oh, he's in his hands, and Webb had it. And what a great setup right there. Steven just couldn't pull it down. So nice play by 67 to disrupt it. But nicely set up play, and Troy threw a nice ball, and Steven almost came down with it. And that's take one spin move, and that kid can run like the wind. So it's fourth down here, and not the greatest field position. So you might see Lucas boot this one. Looks like this might be a kick by Lucas. They're trying to do a little misdirection here, and he does kick it. It's a good kick, very good kick, a great bounce for Redding. So it's going to pin him deep inside, right down to the five. Let it go. Keep going. Down to the four-yard line.
Nice.
What a kick
very
by
nice
Fleming.
Kick.
Great job. They tried a little bit of misdirection, thinking that these guys are going to be up there. They didn't have anyone but to return it. Great job by the coaching staff on that play, and they pinned them back deep. So let's see if this And the second time around, we've seen our defense really bear down on their second series. Let's see what they second taste Lawrence here. Let's see what they can do. Okay, it's going to be first and 10 from the 4-yard line after the beautiful, beautiful punt by Fleming. It's got him in motion. Oh, there's movement. It's
going
to be half the distance to the goal line. So they're going to move this thing back to the 2 and make it first and 12 coming up. So we'll come right back. Okay, here we go. It's going to be first and 10, first and 12 now with the pushback, and they are in their own end zone here. He keeps himself, gets stacked up. Good job. He drives it for 3 or 4 yards and then gets spun around, but nice keeper to gain a little bit of room, and he gets about 4 yards. It's going to be second and maybe eight coming up, so nice little job to get a little breathing room there, but it's second and eight upcoming. Okay, here we go. Second down and call it eight. Traditional wishbone formation now. He hands it off right up the middle, and he gets stacked right there. Fleming all over
him. They all stuffed him.
Right in there. Who else is on top of him there is number 22, Damari, 43, Barboza. So great job. He doesn't get really anywhere. And it's going to be a very big third and six upcoming here because, like we were just talking about off camera, they stop him here. They do not want to go for fourth with that type of field position. So let's see if the Rockets can come up with a big play on third. Say third and a long six right here.
Need to hold them right here.
They're in a throwing formation right here. He moves them in here. It's a hand up the middle just like the last one.
Stuffed.
But this one's stuffed out right there. I think that's
Lucas
up the middle. And Dan O'Connor was in there, number 44. I think it was Dan Junta.
Yeah.
So nice job. They stopped him. It's fourth and five here. And this is really rolling the dice unless they kick this thing. I think they might have to kick it, and that would be great if the guys can get back. I think they're going to have let him kick away.
Yeah.
They're going to let not send Pollock back, but we'll see. They might want him in there defending.
See what they're going
to
do.
Down to watch the count. They are set up to actually make a play here. This could be a huge play. He's telling them watch the count. Don't get pulled off sides. He's trying to do it. calls timeout. So they try to call Danny Damari saying, Oki, don't call, don't jump the count. Redding does a nice job holding on there, and now they're going to rethink this fourth down. Okay, it looks like they are setting up for a kick here. Got a unique formation here. Three guys trying to block one of these guys. They want to make sure that he doesn't take off, though.
Yep. Right, here we go. They got Steven back.
So he gives it a shot. He does kick it, and it's not a great kick. Let it go. Oh. Don't touch it, boys. Don't touch it. All right, it gets into Lawrence bounce there, but Redding's going to take over. First and 10 from the 30-yard line. So beautiful play.
That was perfect.
Hey, that's what we talked about, the second go-around for the defense, and they look great right there, and the Rockets are going to take over first and 10 with awesome field position. Harrigan in now. Lucas Fleming. This might be this is a new formation right here for these guys. I formation. Harrigan, you'll see him probably follow right Lucas right up the gut following. He does fall. Lucas got some room in front of him, and he drives it down for a quick 6 or 7. So beautiful run by Lucas on first down. It's going to be second and short upcoming. Okay, here we go. Cameraman extraordinaire Andy Fatino joining us again. He's a weatherman. He brought us good weather. Same setup right here. Now it's Lucas the other way. Lucas cuts outside. He gets tripped. Gets tripped up. So they got a good athlete there. A couple of guys that come through, and the offensive line needs a little bit bigger of a push. But Lucas may be content to keep this one between the tackles. Put your head down and don't try to get outside. We'll leave that to number 33 coming in right now, Stephen Webb. Oh, right now it's going to be Harrigan again under center. But this time it's Webb and Beckenhuis looking for 4 for a first down. He's in quick, and Steven puts his head down and drives down very close to the first down near the 20. I'm going to call it about a foot here. Maybe he has it.
Depends on the spot. Yeah, about a foot.
He's going to be really just about 6 inches short here, and I think this is obviously four down territory here, but I think are we on the fourth down? I think we are. So big play right here for just a couple of feet. These Lawrence guys trying to jump the count here, but look for the big man, Fleming, right up the gut. Hand off to Lucas. He gets met immediately, but he keeps driving. Oh, he's still on his feet. Wow, you know what? The kid does not give up, and that first time you hit him doesn't matter. Great push by Lawrence right there. They almost had him stop, but drives it for a first down. We get a new set of 4 here at about inside the 15-yard line. So
we got Redding,
knocking on the doorstep here.
We got our own little Gronkowski with that guy.
Nice. Okay, right here it's going to be first 10 from about the 16. Same setup, Lucas back deep. It's a handoff to Lucas. He puts his head down. He drives it forward for about 3 or 4. Why not keep going with what's working? So nice job for a stop there, only a short gain there, but it's going to be, let's call it 2nd and 7 upcoming. Okay, here we go. Same setup. Look for Fleming. It's a handoff to Fleming. There's a flag on the play. It happened almost immediately, so I don't know if that was maybe an encroachment. He threw it right before the snap, and it's offsides on Lawrence. Beautiful. They'll take that 5 and take the play over again, I'm sure.
Yeah. They are trying to jump that line.
They're trying to get in there. That's the only way they think they can get to Fleming, and it's cost them on a couple of encroachments here, and this is going to be move them very close to a first down, if not have it. And they're going to replay second down with maybe just a yard upcoming. So fortunate for the Rockets inside the 10 now. It is 2nd and 1 yard right here. Look for more Fleming. And you get it. And Lucas goes up. He drives it still on his feet and drives down to the 2-yard line. Like a bully, takes it there. First down, and in comes a whole new offense right here for the Rockets. And I tell you, this is one of the things that's tough, Andy. We talk about a team that has 19 players. You're not worried about minimum plays.
Yeah.
You got a team that has 33, and it is a battle every day just to get the kids in there to follow the rules. So no one does it better than Coach Junter and his staff, and it's going to be first and goal here from about the 3-yard line. Look for Lucas following Beckenhuis. He gets stopped. He's still on his feet. Oh, he drives it. And is he in? Oh, he's very close. Ugh. Wow, Lucas has not gone down. He is on the 1-inch line right here. So the Rockets are knocking on the doorstep here with 1:50 to go in the half, which is beautiful. You see him try to run this thing down. You see Troy Pollock coming in here with the play, and we're going to come back in a second. Take it yourself. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Troy is in there right now. I think he's got room over to the left. He's going to go Fleming up the middle. And Fleming runs in easy. Nice job. This time they go left. So right behind number 70, I think, big Lynchy with a nice play. Went right over his back, and Fleming's in easy. So the Rockets get on the board first here. And with 1:14 to go in the half, they score. And I would expect that you might see one here, not two. Yeah, well, we'll see, because two could mean the difference of this game if they kick it. But they were probably 1 for 3 last time. So you're going to see a go for one upcoming here, and it's going to be a big one.
Yep,
we're still on here, so like you said, look for Fleming. They're stacked very heavy. You're going to do the same exact thing. And there he goes, Lucas. Oh, he gets stuck right there. He tries to stab, but he doesn't get in. So, hey, credit Lawrence right there. That's a very, very big stop there that, as we've seen a number of different times this year, has come back to have big implications in the game later. So, great, great drive there on really excellent field position from the 30. They've got this thing down to about a minute left, and Lucas is going to be set to kick off shortly. Okay, here we go. Lucas Fleming set to kick. He's counting off his numbers. 1:13 left, although we know the clock is a little bit off. Nice kick by Lucas. Oh, it's past him. Wow, get on him right now. He's got some room. Take him right there. Oh, nice play by Dusan Pavlović. Oh, boy, almost pushes him back inside the 10, and they're going to set up Lawrence with unbelievably poor field position again, and what a pushback right there. Great kick by Fleming. Gets past him. I do think he touched it, too. Mm-hmm. Barboza right in there. I think that was Troy Pavlović who went in and took him down. I'm not sure. I'll have to take a look at that because we are so far up. I'm just happy to say Redding did it.
Yeah, I think I got a nosebleed.
Oh my gosh, this is I can't see nearly the far enough here. I'm just guessing right now, but it's going to be 1st and 10. There's less than a minute here to go, so look for a little bit of maybe some big tries here. They're deep. They don't want to give Redding the ball back, so let's see if they pull any trickery here. Right there, he turns, spins around. He's got a little bit of time. Now he's going to keep it himself. He's got room. Oh, stay on him. Nice job. Nate right there, but he does take it for about 5 or 6. So he gets a little bit of breathing room there. I think they might have called timeout here, but we're not exactly sure that has been the case all year, Andy. Never look at the clock on the thing. You have to look. He's checking the time right now. We'll see if we can get it and come back in a sec. Okay, here we go. It's 2nd and about 5 here. Not a lot of time left on the clock here. It's going to be an inside handoff. No, he keeps it. That same thing there. Nice job. Go for that ball. Beautiful play by Richmond. Overcomes, I think it's Dan Junta to help out. And Zach Kenyon, 51, was there too. So Keith Richmond did a real nice job there. And it's about, say, 3rd and 2 here. But I think the goal here is just to keep the ball out of Redding's hands and get to the half. And they will get the ball back at the half. So at this stage, they don't want to do anything dumb and turn the ball over. Says less than 30 on the clock.
QB's in the shotgun formation.
See if we can get Steve Webb with a push on there. Oh, the ball went on the ground. Oh, it is still on the ground. Wow. And if Redding comes up with this ball, wow, this could be exactly what we talked about. Yeah,
Daniel,
the Rockets got it. They got 7 seconds left on the clock here. Someone's hurt over here, though. We're going to take a look at him. Someone's on the ground. They got to get someone out to look at him. I'm not sure who that is right there. But they got to get the staff out here to take a look at him. But they turn the ball over, and it looks like Keith Richmond, maybe 21.
Yep.
Wow, Keith would be a big loss here, and he's looking like he's in pain here.
So
we're going to come back and see what we have. There's just a few seconds left on the clock here from the 20. You're going to see the Rockets try to go to the end zone when we come back, and we'll come back in a second, see if Keith's all right. 3 guys back now. This is a different setup. They were calling this one the 3 amigos here. It goes to Webb. We have Webb's going to follow. He's going to follow. If he gets outside, he could get him. He cuts back. Oh, boy. If they can call a timeout, we'll see what it is. But Webb, oh, boy. He was going to follow
Lucas.
He was going to follow Lucas. He had a little room there and had one guy to beat. He slowed him up just enough. And now it's going to be, right now, the only thing that's going to harm these guys is the clock. And I don't really know how much time is left. So we'll come back. Another timeout for Redding here. And they love to get one in the end zone. This one could go. Okay, here we go. 2nd down. Not exactly sure how much time is left, but look for Troy to put this one in the air. He's in the shotgun.
QB is in the shotgun formation. Looks like
Got Danny next to him.
He does. He looks back to throw. He runs outside. Troy throws it. Oh! He had Steven. Just led him a little bit too far, and unfortunately he was running running on his offhand, so he had to throw across his body. Just led Steven a little bit too far and had him, and there was a little guy on Steven. He's pointing at him right now saying, that kid's too big for me. So there is they do stop the clock here, and then you got to see them try to set up another pass. Okay, here we go. Call it. I don't know if it's second or third down. I think it's second. Look for Troy to throw this one again. He goes back to throw it. He looks. He throws it over. He's got Webb, and Webb's going to go in. Wow,
yeah.
What a play. Beautiful setup right there before the half. And that is going to be a killer right there for Lawrence, turning the ball over with under a minute to go. What a great play. Troy had to make an athletic move to get around it. The first guy, I think, was Barbeau's underneath, who wasn't open. Webb swings out, and he has him wide open and hits him. So beautiful play here. And you may see they look like they're going to go for one coming up here. So beautiful play before that happened. The Rockets may have just put a dagger in these guys. But we talked about turnovers, and right now for the first game all year, the turnovers have favored the Rockets, and they just really made the Hurricanes of Lawrence here pay.
I think I just saw Tom Brady out on that field.
Here we go. Underneath, it's Pollock. Let's look for our boy number 24. He gets it. Wow, he came in immediately.
Quick.
Wow, that guy was in the backfield quick. But, hey, with just ticks left in the clock, Reading is 12, Lawrence 0. Lawrence will be getting the ball back in the second half, but I think that's probably going to do it here. I don't know if there's any who knows how much time is left in this thing. They're obviously going to have a chance to kick it off. So the goal for the Rockets here, stay in your lane, take care of your business here, and we'll move on to the second half. Okay, here we go. Luke is set to kick off here, and the Rockets don't want to get too crazy here. Stay in your lane, make your tackle, push this thing to the second half. But what a great play by the Rockets here.
Kick this thing deep.
Okay, oh, wow. Good play right there. He tries to squib it. I think the goal was to squib it through there to let the clock run out. But they may have a shot here to throw a play here, or that may be the half. We're not sure. Hey, good to see Keith Richmond running back out there after he was shaken up. But look for these guys to try something with a few ticks. The Rockets don't want to make any mistakes here, especially after scoring then. It's going to looks like motion here. It's inside hand up to 21. He's got room. He's got room right there, and he gets around. Troy Pollock does a nice job pushing him out. Let's hope that's enough, but that's the top athlete there. And I have no idea how much time. It's been 5 seconds on the clock here, Andy, for about, I don't know, minute
forever.
And a half. Well, that's a first down there. Nice job by Pollock and Zach Kenyon to push him out. But they are hurrying right now. See if they get something happening. Beckenhughes comes in for Kenyon. It's a pitch right here. Another inside. Oh, look at a triple reverse here. He's got one guy to beat. He's got to get it. You got to run him out right here, and they do it. Nice job.
Nice.
Fleming runs it out, but they get it down to the 25-yard line. Damari and Fleming, so they got a big yardage there. And the Rockets definitely don't want to give up something here before the half. We thought we were squeaking up before the half, but now Lawrence is pushing right here.
Love to know how much time is left.
This is where I can't see anything. I got to lean out the window. Now that more trickery here, and this time he keeps it. Oh, he gets, wow, runs
Uh-oh.
Over a couple guys. Gets it down to the 15-yard line. So that play's worked a couple of times here, but I can't believe that they have any time left here.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, it looks like it gets to the half. So, wow, nice job by the Rockets. A couple of big plays. That's the old bend, don't break right there, Andy.
Yep.
And it doesn't matter. You know what? All Zet did is end up tiring out the Lawrence guys, a couple of the guys, for a couple of meaningless plays at the end. But nice job by Reading to sort of do the old prevent defense there. And we're going to move into the second half here with the Rockets 12 and Lawrence 0. Yep. Okay, here we go. Starting the second half here with Lucas Fleming set to kick off. Lawrence will get the ball back when the Rockets did a nice job to hold him at the very end. They scored late in the first. It's a kick down the middle. That's a live ball. I'm just going to go get that thing. Oh, boy. Who was that in there? Jeez. 21 Keith Richmond.
Wow.
No ill effects from him getting writhing in pain about 10 minutes ago. Comes in and puts a huge lick on this guy. And He looks, hey, it's great to see Richmond back out there. He looks like he's suffering no ill effects there, and he puts a nice lick on this guy, and it's going to be first and 10 here for Lawrence from the 40 upcoming. Okay, here we go, first and 10 from the 40. They're shifting some people around here. Get Damari and Webb on either corner here. It's a pitch to number 21. Oh, it's going to be a reverse here. Oh, it looks like a little push there. One guy left to beat. Oh,
was
what a
Webb?
Tackle by Sean nope. Beckenhuis. So they go, Adam, is that Beckenhuis or is that Rush?
That might be Rush.
It's Jeremy Rush. Wow, what a beautiful form tackle.
Yeah.
He gains all of that razzle-dazzle for about a yard and a half. And what a wrap-up by Rush. He has been, I tell you, I don't know if we'd like to use him a little bit more. There's so many good players on this team, though. It's hard to do it. But when you need him, Jeremy's always ready. What a great tackle. Good job for Redding sort of staying home there, right? They try to do a lot of misdirection here. They do it again. Now he tries cutting back. Oh, he does a nice move there. One guy to beat. Oh, boy, number 21's on there. Barboza's on him. Oh, let's see. Oh. They get another flag here on top of it. And let's see. They might call maybe an extra hit late. So nice run by number 21. And there's a face mask on Redding. It's going to tack on. I don't know if it's going to tack on 5 or another 15. If it's 15, we got big problems here. But 21 is their go-to guy. And I think that was at the end. He's trying to wave and say there is a – I don't know if they're going to wave it off or they're going to move him down
nope,
here.
So they're going 15.
There is a flag. They're going to move them way back.
To the 25, 26.
Unfortunately, the Rocket's going to take over here. It's going to be first and almost inside the red zone here.
Ready?
Yep. Okay, first and 10 here after the big gain and tack on 15 more with a face mask.
It's going to be first and 10 at the 26.
This is exactly what Lawrence needs to do here. Another play sort of cuts back. That play's worked before. And he gets wrapped up there.
I
think that was Fleming in there and Damari, 22 and 24, going high-low on him. And he does get a little bit of a short gain there. He's close. Maybe no gain at all. You know, part of the thing is they pitch that ball back almost 7 yards, yeah. Andy. They got to get 7 yards, get to back to the line of scrimmage. And they do a little bit of misdirection. They look like he's going one way, fall another. And it's going to be second and 10 upcoming. Okay, here we go, second and 10. A little bit of confusion on the line here for Lawrence. Number one in motion. It's a handoff right up the gut to 21. He's got a huge room in front of him. Wow! He doesn't get pulled down. It was number, I think it was 41. Beckenhuis was in there, had him. Rush almost rips the ball away, but tell you, he rips it off, and that's another first down to the 10-yard line. And we might be very close to 15-yard line, sorry. But it's going to be first and 10 from the 15 here. So nice run by Big 21. And this is exactly what Lawrence needed to do, is answer and answer quickly to get themselves back in this game. This is going to be a big test for Redding to see if they can hold them. Two different guys in motion. He's going to be a keeper. He's going to try to throw this ball. Oh, he does throw it. Oh, throws it away smartly. Smart play by the quarterback there. He had nowhere to go. Redding stayed at home, and Rush was right there. No one really even out in the pattern. And so it's going to be second and 10 upcoming. A lot of this Rocket defense right now. Some good plays here. Love to see a nice strip down here again. Lawrence has put the ball on the ground a couple of times. They're moving the ball well in this series, though. Right up the middle, number 21, big run. He gets stacked up there. He's still on his feet. So he runs it down inside the 10, close to the 5, and it's going to be, oof. He's got only about a yard and a half for a first down, but this is going to be third down, clearly four down territory.
Oh, God, yeah.
So they get a couple more snaps here, and it's going to be asking a lot for the Rockets to keep them at bay. Lawrence coach imploring them, guys, give me that first down. I'd like to get four more shots at it from inside the 10. It's a keeper right up the middle, and he's got the first, I think. So the keeper, they've used that twice effectively, and they get a first down. It's going to be first and goal here. So first and goal upcoming for Lawrence. It says about 6 minutes left in the third here, and they're trying to get on the board. Okay, here we go. It's first and goal here. new formation here. Everyone's stacked up. We don't know who's going to keep it. They just sort of push forward. So they stack it up. This is one of those things. It looks like they got in the end zone. He's got his hands up for the touchdown. So it says offsides by Redding. So I don't know. I don't see it. They call it a touchdown, so decline. So they do get in there. That was a play that looked very much like Drakett's play. Instead of a bunch of guys in close, you don't know who's going to get the ball. So they do get the ball, and it looks like it's now 12-6, and we're going to see the extra point. We don't know if it's going to be one or they're going to try two. You might as well try one because a regular touchdown will put you over the top. So very, very big play for the extra point here. Very big play. Here we go. Rockets would love to have a pushback here. Look for number 21 to get that ball. He's their big athlete. Inside handoff. Number one's right there. He's got one guy to beat. He doesn't do it. Wow. Is that Jeremy Rosh out there, number 11? I can't see that far. And I think it is. And what a play. Nice trickery there. Rosh stays home and comes up and clips him. So beautiful. That was actually wasn't Rosh. It was number 15, Patrick Harrigan. So give Patrick credit, pumping up Jeremy, which he deserves it too. But that was a beautiful play by Harrigan. And that one's going to be a really big play right there. That's huge right now to keep that at least a touchdown difference coming up here. And the Rockets are going to get the ball back with who knows how much time left in the third quarter.
I've given up at this point.
Sometimes we could try to hear it out here, but we're so far away, I can't hear anything. I feel like we're up in space up here, Andy.
A different planet.
So listen, as you can tell, when we get to playoff time, it's all business up here.
Business. All the time.
Yeah. So, all right. Well, listen, we got to get going right here. I think, who do we have back? It looks like Barboza and Webb. Let's watch this kick. Looks like it might have been offsides there. Nice pickup right there is Patrick. He cuts back. He's got some room ahead of him. Cut up, Patrick. There you go. Cut forward. He's still on his feet. Hold on to that ball. Beautiful. Blow the whistle, guys. Feel
They're
free.
All stacked up.
Okay, there you go. So beautiful run back by Harrigan. The Rockets could have excellent field position. First and 10 from the 44. Hey, we've seen this one before, too, where we got Webb. This is a new setup. Webb, Damari, and Fleming in the background. What do we got here? They have too many guys on the field here. One, two. Sagala, oh boy. Okay, so no problem there. The Rockets had too many guys. They moved that back 10 or 5? No, only 5.
There you go.
So it's going to be first 10. We had 12 guys on the line. Would have liked to see them run a play, see if they get some stuff out there. But we have the coaches imploring one of the players to get off. And now it's going to be first and 15 from just about inside midfield. There's Webb. He's going to keep it. Oh, boy. Webb gets outside. He's got a little bit of room. Steven gets around the outside. He cuts back. He's still on his feet. Steven's still on his feet. Gets pushed out around the 12. You hit me in the head with the boom over here, Andy. But what a run by Steven Webb. Now, that's a new setup that those guys haven't seen all year, and that's what Coach Junta puts in his bag of tricks. They have three backs there. They have Lucas Fleming, who they've been given a steady dose of early. They go to Webb, get speed outside. They also have Damari in there. And so Lawrence, coach, imploring him here. But, wow, huge play by Webb. It's going to be first and 10 from the 14. Cameraman Fatino commenting on the massive size of my head that he moved the boom arm in. We almost didn't see Webb doing this. Here's the same setup right here. Just switch the other side. Trying to jump it. He's going to follow Lucas. If he stays behind, he's going to run past him.
Yeah.
And he dives forward very close to the first down, close to the five-yard line. So Steven saw some daylight. He's going to take it.
He couldn't wait for Lucas.
He couldn't wait for him, and he still drives it for a nice probably 9-yard gain. I guess maybe he stepped out a little bit early, call it 7, but it's going to be second and short coming up here around the 6-yard line. Oh, it's going to be second and call it short here. Same setup. Three different guys they can go to here. This time Lucas follows Webb. He puts his head up. He drives forward. He is very close, if not in the end zone there. He's down to the 1-foot line. That's going to be a first down, too. First and goal from the 1-foot line. And look for Fleming again. I don't know if he could be stopped, certainly if there's 1 foot here. So this could be a really, really powerful answer here for Redding coming right back after Lawrence gets on the board. And you weren't going to keep Lawrence off it. They're too good of a team, but what an answer if they could pull it off here. So Webb's going to be in there. This is where they need to take care of the ball. We got Webb, Fleming, Damari. It goes to Steven. Steven puts his head down. He gets met immediately, but he's going to get in there. He's got to be in. They say that he stopped him. Wow, I don't know how that happened. That wasn't the greatest spot in the world. But we'll see what happened there. That was unbelievable. I mean, all Steven needed was a foot. He put his head down, and I think he got it. But no good spot there, but they got three more shots at it here. He's telling them to hurry it up here. See if they go back to Lucas on this one. This time it's Webb again. It's to Lucas, and Lucas drives forward, and he's in. Beautiful play. That went a little bit misdirection and couldn't go to either one. Steven leads forward, and Lucas falls right behind him and drives it in for a touchdown. So beautiful play there by, the big ones on that one were huge run by Steven Webb on that first and 15 to start it off. And then a nice play by Lucas to finish it off. Steven had a couple of great plays in that series. And when he can get outside, there's no one who can catch him. So let's see what we're going to do here. Probably go for one. We got Troy Pollock in there. We got Steven Webb back in the eye. It's going to be a hand. Oh, Roy's going to throw it. He's got a couple of guys. He may take it himself. He throws it. Oh, he hits him in the hands. He had him. He had him with the extra point. Just hits it in his hands and drops it. Unfortunately, I think that might have been Jeremy over there. But nice job by Troy to hold and hold and hold. He had Rosh open and just dropped the ball. So that one unsuccessful as well. So the Rockets got three touchdowns. They don't get any extra points. But I tell you, it's nice to be up 12 with 2 minutes to go, at least what it says 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. We might have missed that first down play. It was a good one. Jeremy Rush took a pop on it. Bounced right back up, though. It's going to be first and 10 from the 22. Let's see what these Rockets can do. Get in the backfield. He throws it back. Oh, boy, he's on him.
Oh,
throws it underneath. Oh, Fleming was all over him. He threw it out there, desperation. And Keith Richmond was right there, and Damari was there. They almost came up with something. So big pressure from Lucas right over the middle. And that's the stuff you like to see here. So second and 10 upcoming. Okay, second and 10 play here. Look like they're going to try to go back to the ground here. It was successful on that one. Oh, here's one of these big plays they've seen right here.
Here we go again.
They're going to put three guys on him and see what they come up with. He's going to try to throw it behind him. He's going to tell Harrigan to go get him, and Webb, go get him. He hikes, he throws it very quickly. They make the play. He's got a seam. So nice job. He gets driven out by Lucas. So not really a big game. Very well defended. So that guy had to get moving quick. He has Oki over the nose on that play. You got Harrigan and Webb on either side. And that kid's got to turn and throw it immediately.
And we saw that play a lot last week.
We saw it with Methuen trying it, and there was some success, and they did say they do something similar. And this is where you start to get these sort of desperation plays. This is a third and like maybe eight here. And this is a huge play. They're probably going to go for it. There's not enough time on the clock here. They got to get back in this game, so they do not want to turn this ball over. 25-yard line, inside handoff. He's right there. He moves up. Nice cutback. He spins off, so he's very close to the first down. So he does the inside handoff to number 21. He's the guy they use all the time, and they're very close. They may give him the first here. If they don't, it's going to be a foot. That's the quarter. Okay, so the end of the quarter, we're going to come back shortly. Okay, first down from about the 31-yard line here. Fourth quarter, Rockets up 18-6. He goes back to throw. He throws it long and deep. It's over Harrigan. He's wide open. Big, huge play. Troy's the last guy to beat. He takes him down inside the 10, but he lofted that ball up, and number one got behind Patrick Harrigan. He pulled the ball in for an absolutely huge play, 70-yard gain here. And that's a huge play for the Rockets right now. Troy might have been a little bit banged up there, but he was the last line of defense. He pulls him down. But a great pass play right there, and those big plays can get you right back in the game.
Great run by Troy to get him.
Beautiful, beautiful. Nice pass, big number one. Pulls it in. And that's a huge play. First and 10 from the 13-yard line. Huge pass. Inside number 21. He cuts back, still on his feet. A lot of people pulling on him now. So he gains probably 3 or 4 tough yards there, but you see the clock start to tick when they keep it on the ground. And anytime the clock is ticking, that helps the Rockets. Second and call it 5 from the 9-yard line. In a running formation here, but he is in the shotgun. He can't, inside handoff to 21. He drives it down. Looks like he's going to be in, and he is. I don't see him. They do finally give it to him. So nice run by number 21. He's a good athlete, and they hand it right up the middle, and he goes in for the score. So 3 quick plays, just under a minute and a half in the fourth, and Lawrence gets on the board, makes it 18-12, and they can cut it to within a touchdown if they can get the extra. Okay, they're getting right in here. They don't want this Rocket D to rest. Last play was a beautiful play by Patrick Harrigan, who stayed at home. More misdirection. They put Fleming out on the outside now with Steven Webb. Oh, they're going to try to kick this thing.
Oh.
Which is strange. If they kick it, they obviously get 2 points. They're going to try it. He goes. It looks like he's got it. Beautiful. Right down the middle, and he gets 2 points. And this is a game in a hurry. Now it's 18-14. So Rockets are going to get the ball back, and it's going to be a critical offensive drive for them because they're within a touchdown. Sort of an odd call right there because all you really need is one. But, hey, listen, if it works, it works. And they got 2. So right now with about 8 minutes to go in the game, it's Reading 18, Lawrence 14, and this is a good one. It's going to come down to the wire, I think, Andy.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, the Rockets going to get the ball back here. 3 huge pass play and 2 other plays. They come in and score. It's a nice kick right there. It goes to, let's see, I think that is maybe Barboza. Dante cuts back. He's got to hold on to that ball, and he does. So nice job. Nice run back by Dante. Going to be great field position for the Rockets right around midfield. And this is going to be a huge series for the Rocket offense. They need to accomplish a couple things here with 7.5 minutes plus in the fourth quarter here. They need to take some time off the clock, and they need to score. And they need to take care of the ball because, obviously, the Lawrence team has some quick strike ability. So here we go. We're going to be 1st and 10 upcoming. Okay, here we go. Coach imploring the D. This is where that D could get tired. So this is where the Rockets could run them down. It's a keeper for Steven. He's going to follow Lucas. He cuts outside. Number 21, too, does a nice job sticking with him. And that's one where you'd like to see maybe Lucas run a little bit harder and faster. Steven's obviously a faster runner. You'd like to see Lucas get out and have him follow the big man. Steven's been getting outside. He only takes that for a short game. Oh, it's going to be 2nd and 9 here upcoming. And here's that familiar setup we haven't seen all year. It's Webb and Fleming. This one times to Fleming. It's an inside hand up to Dante. Dante cuts up, and he's going to be close to the first down. So that's a play we haven't seen either. And Barboza carries it very close to the first. Call it 3rd and 1 foot. So nice looking play there. They can go any number of different ways with that setup. All right, here we go. We're talking about this probably being 4 down territory. We need a yard here for the first down. Goes to Lucas, he follows Steven. 1st down and more, nice job. I like that, he can go to Webb, he can go to Lucas. It goes right to Lucas, he follows Webb for the easy 1st down, and the clock is ticking and the Rockets are marching. So let's keep it going just like that. The Rockets are doing exactly what we thought. We would take some time off the clock, get some 1st downs, and let's put it in the end zone here. So Lucas comes in with a play. Okay, here we go here. It is gonna be 1st and 10 from the 40-yard line. Similar setup right now. Oh, right there. Rockets jump, and it's going to cost them 5 yards there. So snap count jump right there. It's going to be 1st and 15, pushing the Rockets the other way. Not the time we want a penalty, but, hey, 1st down anyway. So we'll see what's coming up next. I think Coach Junta calls timeout.
Good.
Okay, 1st and 15 right now after the motion on the Rockets. This one goes to Webb. He's going to follow. Look, oh, great play right there. Number 21 comes in, and he makes a nice tackle on him. So Steven gets about 2 yards here. It's going to be second and 14 upcoming. Troy Pollock comes back in the game at quarterback. May see a more traditional setup here. Looks like we get Dan Junta in the backfield now, number 44. It's going to be a look like a pass here to Pollock. Pollock looks up. He throws it over. He's got him. Steven's wide open. He just couldn't cut back, but he's going to be very close to a first down. Beautiful play by Pollock to Webb. And I tell you, Troy comes in. He's slinging the ball like he's Jim Zorn out there, right?
Yes.
He was number 7, I think. He was a lefty, though, for a nice play right there, and it's definite four-down territory, so big play to Steven. I think Steven tried to cut back there, and just slipped, but good play. If Steven did cut back, there was only one guy to beat, and in comes Damari with the play. A big, probably two plays to get the first here, and this is huge play for Reading. We have Webb, and we got Fleming in the backfield. It goes to Lucas. Lucas follows Steven, drives it forward. Oh, nice job. This
should
actually stop him. He's very close.
Close.
Very close. He's on the 30-yard line. Let's see.
Short.
He's going to be inches short, and you're going to see the Rockets definitely go for it here on fourth down. We'll see what they do next. Okay, they're calling for the chains here, and this is a huge play. The Rockets certainly go for it on fourth, but he's going to test this thing out where it was. And let's see what they call.
Oh, my God.
First down for Reading. Wow, that is a huge play. Love it. Love to see the chains come out, Andy. Huh? Perfect. So that's a huge first down for the Rockets. 30-yard line. New set of four on the downs, and it says 436. I don't know if we can believe it, but the Rockets are doing just what we wanted them to do. Troy comes in here now. Every time they see number 7, they're thinking pass. So let's see what they come up with next. And Troy's in there at quarterback. Jeremy Rosh is split left. We also have Lucas in there as well. Damari also split left. Shotgun here. It's an inside handoff right there. He's got to cut up. I think that's Barboza.
Looks like Barboza, yeah.
Barboza cuts up, and he gets probably 2 or 3, and it's going to be 2nd and 8. Okay, here we go. It's going to be 2nd and 8 here. Steven Webb and Fleming in the backfield. It's to Steven. He's going to follow Lucas. Got to get a block. Steven gets around the outside. Nice tackle. Beautiful tackle over there. 22 takes him down. And I'll tell you, that Steven, perfect tackle there. Cuts him down for like 2. It's going to be 3rd and 8 coming up here. The Rockets certainly, like you said, in 4-down territory. But we don't want to give this ball back. They want to get another first down here. Here we go. It's 3rd and 8 here. Rockets, different look right here. This one's going to Troy. He's going to throw the ball. Oh, they got some movement. They might move them back. Wow, I think they might have some motion on the Rockets, and they do. And now it's going to make it 3rd and 12, and you'll see them obviously showing the hand that they're going to pass on that one. So let's see what they come up with now. And Coach Junta a little frustrated there. They had called a timeout for that play to use it, and now they saw what the play was going to be, and they lose it. He might just say, do the same thing. Third and 12 is a big difference here than 3rd and 8. Certainly still 4-down territory, I think, but obviously these Lawrence team is a quick strike offense. Troy goes back. He's going to look. He throws it back underneath. He's got someone. Oh, no. He's open.
He was looking
upfield. I think it was Dante. He was looking upfield and drops the ball. So Dante was wide open. Troy throws across his body, and Dante was thinking about running with it first and got to make that first catch and then move with it, and it's going to be 4th down here. So that stops the clock, too. It's not exactly what they wanted. Troy made a nice play. He had a couple of different options to throw and can't connect with Barboza. All right, so the Rockets here, 4th down and 14. You're probably going to see them make a play here. There's no real net gains here. If they kick it in the end zone, it's going to go to the 20 anyway. So this is a huge play here for Pollock. Look for him to pass. And he's going to. He's going to roll out. He's got room in front of him if he wants to pull down and run, and he does. He cuts back. He's still at his feet, but he doesn't get it. Oh, they stopped very short. Troy had some room. He needed to make one more move, and he's a yard short. They're going to turn the ball over on downs. And Lawrence in their quick strike offense, this is going to be a huge test for the Rocket D. They turn the ball over on downs, and it's going to be 80 yards for these guys to go because they're going to need a touchdown. And who knows how much time is left on the clock here. I guess we'll have to pay attention when they really do call a two-minute warning. But this is going to be a huge test for the Rocket D right here. Lawrence gets the ball back, and we saw what they can do. Okay, here we go. First down. A lot of guys split left. Going to see if he can get behind the Rocket defenders again. Danny's staying with him. He throws it out there. Oh, he drops the ball. That is actually, that's a nice play. He picks it up. He can run because that's a lateral. Oh, boy.
Smart
wow.
Move, smart
very,
move.
Very smart play by that by number 21, and he's been their workhorse. He drops the ball when it was actually a lateral, so he had a chance to possibly throw it, but he runs it for a first down. Clock ticking. First and 10 here for Lawrence. They throw it this way. Oh, boy. Number 21,
kicked.
Richmond comes across. It's got to be movement on Lawrence. They're going to move them back, and they do. But Keith Richmond came in there. Gosh, he could have picked that thing off and walked to the house.
Home.
So it's going to be first and 15 here, but the clock stops, and it's very close to 2 minutes. Okay, first and 15 here. Get some guys shifted around. Richmond goes right. Webb on the left. Lucas right over the center. Looking to croak somebody there. They got someone in motion. It's a pitch out to number 21. He's got some guys. He can cut up, and he does, but he gets met immediately. 41.
Nice.
Sean Beckin, he strings him out. Number 43, Barboza in there as well, and Webb. So that's actually maybe a gain of two, and the clock is running. That may be a two-minute warning. I'm not sure. Two-minute warning, so we're at the two-minute warning right now, and it's going to be, it's obviously four-down territory here, but it's going to be third and long.
Yep.
Yeah, sorry, call it second and long because of the penalty. Looking for a pass here. They don't want to let anyone get behind him. He goes back. He is going to throw. He throws underneath. He's wide open, and he just leads him too far. So it's an incomplete pass. He did have number one, and Patrick's over there. Troy was trying to come over and help, but he did lay off him a little bit. Like maybe let's see a little bit tighter coverage there. The clock is running here. It shouldn't be running because it's an incomplete pass, but we'll see. Yep. Coach is imploring the guys, don't let these guys get behind you. He's imploring Lucas and Oki, get in there. Put some pressure on this guy. They got to move. Big third down here in 15. Oh, he keeps it right at the middle. Huge play. He cuts up, and he's going to be very close to the first down. He gets
it. He's got it.
Wow, what a great call by these guys. They spread it all out, and it's a keeper up the middle for a first down, and he runs it right up the middle. So beautiful call by Lawrence. New set of downs, I believe, unless they call timeout, and they do. Lawrence calls timeout to stop the clock, but it's going to be at midfield, first down. All right, here we go. It's first down. Beautiful call. Risky call, but a beautiful call there for a first down. It's going to be from the 48-yard line. They got to look for him to throw again. They're going to throw a lot here. It's a pitch. It's an inside in. Oh, look at this. He's got some time. Nice play right there.
Stay with him.
Comes
stay with
in,
him. There
stays
you
on
go.
Him. Patrick comes in. I think that's Webb.
With the initial hit.
No,
43
Barboza. Tell you, Dante Barboza made a great play, closed on him, pushed him back, and that's a run, and this clock has to stop unless they, the clock should be running unless they call timeout again, and they're going to be running out of them.
Yeah, they.
So it's going to be second and 11 here on a pushback, and they do, they look
they
like they do call timeout.
Yep.
They had to have, so I called another timeout. They must not have too many left, so look for them to put the ball in the air. Okay, here we go. It's, I don't know if it's, I think it's second down here at 11. And I can't believe that there's any timeouts left. There might be a one left for a Lawrence here. But these guys got to put the ball in the air. He's going to roll. He's got an option here. He throws it. He's going to keep it. He's going to, oh, beautiful play right there by Fleming. Fleming wraps him up. Great coverage back there. And that was a coverage sack right there with Pollock, Beckenhuis. And I believe who else was out there covering? Barboza was out there, and Lucas comes in and rips him down. So it's going to be third and 15 with a minute and it says minute and a half left here. This is a huge play, clearly four down territory, but it pushes them back, and they're going to have to put the ball in the air here, I think, unless we see one of these other trick plays. It's a pitch out here. He's going to go back. Oh, number one's got the ball on the outside. He's got a little room. One guy to beat here. Oh, he does beat him. Oh, but he takes it close to first down. He pushes him out. So it's going to be very, very close. I think he's short.
He's about 3 to 4
yards. 3 yards short, and it's going to be fourth down. And this is the play of the game right here. If the Rockets can make a stop, it will be over. And they're going to need 3 yards here. And they're right now, Coach Damari on the field imploring the D. Step it up. It's going to be fourth down and about 3 yards to go. And this is the play of the game to keep this thing going. They're under a minute. Let's see what they have up their sleeve. And the Rockets would love to have a stop. Here we go. Fourth down play. They need three. Looks like it's definitely going to be a pass here unless they see someone in motion. He could try to keep it himself again. He does keep it right up the middle, and he dives for it.
He gets it.
Wow, they've done it again. That thing right up the middle, and I think they even expected it. They had Oki and Fleming right there, and credit the quarterback. He dives for the first down. So now there looks like another call timeout here. It has to be the last one. They have 43 yards to go, and they need six. There's only 30 seconds left to go. Look for them to put the ball in the air. This is a game of clock management right here. There are no timeouts left, and they're obviously going to put the ball in the air, and they're telling them, don't let it get behind you. Shotgun here. Oh, the ball's on the ground. That's a dead ball. That's a dead ball right there. They went down. I don't know what they're doing here. He's all over him right there. Beautiful play by Richmond. Comes over, but
how was that not called dead?
I don't know how that ball, I guess he picked it up, but it hit the ground, and he didn't go down to one knee, so it's not dead. I thought it would be dead. He scooped it up. The clock's running. They got 15 seconds left to go here. Huge play. It took all sorts of time off the clock. He's saying, do not get behind you. And he goes back, and he's got to fire it up. He fires it up behind, throws it out of bounds,
nice.
And this looks like 3 seconds left in this game, but who really knows? And let's see if we can find out. Okay, here we go. They're screaming last play here. Looks like it's a last play here. Nothing short of a miracle play.
Oh,
they're
going to
try a trick here. They're going to try it again. They put Oki over the center. They're going to put Dante up there.
Boy, the Colts have got everybody to do this.
Steven Webb and Pat Harrigan are right there. He's going to go under center right here. Oki's over the center. Final play of the game. He's got someone in motion. He's going to hand it off to him. Oh, Harrigan's right there. Troy's going to catch him. And he does. He does.
Yeah.
He catches him, and that's going to be the ball game, folks. Beautiful play, and the Rockets win. Look at Big Tan Damari over there. He's jumping up and down. He's causing the earth to shake over there. It's like Godzilla. I was shaking up here, and the Rockets defense comes up big, and they hold on and win it. Wow, what a game, man. They asked a lot of the Rocket defense there at the very end, and they came up big. That was a really interesting play. They go to number 21. Troy strings them out. They bring them down, and they run out the clock, and the Rockets are moving on to Sunday. I believe that's the EMAS, what we call the EMAS final.
Sure.
And that's going to be Sunday against the winner of Draken and Wakefield, two teams we've already seen. What a great football game, and we'll come back and see you Sunday. Hey, welcome to playoff game number 3 for the Reading Rockets, and this one's going to be a doozy because it's a rematch. The only blemish on the Rockets' record this year is a 7-6 loss to Draken, and the kids have been talking about this one all year, saying we'd love to see him again. They're going to see him again, and they're going to see him with a couple of different players who weren't available last time. Both Steven Webb and Dante Barboza, key big-time athletes for the Rockets, are back. And that's going to give the Rockets a whole new look here. Hey, a couple of guys I wanted to mention that unbelievable Lawrence game. Number 51, Zach Kenyon, made a huge, huge fumble recovery inside before the half that put the Rockets up, helped put the Rockets up 12-0. And then earlier in the game, it was actually a Rocket fumble. Number 73, right over here next to big, tall Dan Junta, Dave Swanson, made a huge heads-up play to keep that drive going. And, you know, we talk about some other things, too, some plays we were talking about afterwards. Big play at the end of the half where they had the huge catch, the Lawrence team. Troy Pollack never gives up on that, right? Never gives up on that play, knocks him out. Yes, they go in 2 plays later. But when they needed an extra minute and a half on the clock late, they didn't get it because there are guys who don't give up here. So the Rockets are getting all fired up here as Drakett makes their way over. And we are looking, it's going to be a good one, isn't it, Andy?
It certainly is.
Andy
nice
Pacino back with us here. It's a grass field here, a little bit of a berm in the middle of it. We played here before. We're going to have to deal with our speakers later. You got the guys at Bill Ricker love to shout it out and scream stuff out.
Hopefully but
we'll deal
loud.
With it. Right here, we're securing the Reading Rockets flag, and we'll come back real soon with this is the Eastern Mass Finals, and we move on to the States, the winner of this one. So let's see if the Rockets have what it takes. They've seen this team before, and we'll be back shortly for the kickoff. And if we remember, Andy, there's a couple real good athletes. Number 24 in particular was a top player for Drake. At 33 was very good as well. So they have some guys who can play, and let's see what the flag, the coin toss comes up with here as we get ready to play here. There's a buzz in the air out here, Andy, on the Reading side. Everyone's all fired up for this rematch.
Yes, they are. And they're all right below us. We're going to get some good noise coming this side.
I like it. Maybe we might be having to call the RCTV sensors if things don't go our way, but.
Ain't that the truth.
All right, let's see where we started. It looks like they're going to separate it here. Reading wins the toss, and they are going to receive. So look for Stephen Webb back deep and Dante Barboza. Reading going to get the ball early here. We'll be back shortly. And here come the boys getting all fired up. Drake is set to kick off here. Dante Barboza, 43, number 33. Stephen Webb is back, too. It looks like it's going to go to Webb. Webb scoops it up. The ball's on the ground. And he stands up and takes it. Oh, he's lucky enough just to pick that up, but Reading is going to take over about the 35-yard line. Steven couldn't quite grab that one. And Rockets going to take over and look for that steady dose of Lucas Fleming and Dan Damari to start this thing. First play from scrimmage here. We got Sean Beckenhuis ahead of Lucas Fleming. We've seen that. It's a familiar one. Look for him to follow 41 right through a hole. He does. Puts his head down. Oh. Lucas gets about 4 or 5 yards. He's still on his feet. Drives it right up to about six or so. So nice rush by Lucas to start. Call it second and five upcoming. Go. Call it second and maybe four here. But now Stephen Webb in the backfield with Damari. I mean, with Beckenhuis. They haven't seen Webb this year. He follows him. Stephen cuts back, gets stacked up, and he only gets a short gain there. It's going to be third and short upcoming.
Goes up the middle, bring up third
and Lucas down. Comes right back in, so it's going to be third and short here. And this is a big play for Reading early on.
Stephen Pinto.
Not the juke. Okay, here we go. Third and short here. Whole new offensive line put in. This one's going to be Harrigan under center. It goes off to Lucas. Lucas goes outside. He gets stacked up. So nice stop right there, and it's going to be fourth down. And the question here is, he's telling him to go up the middle, not cut outside. Bob Junta imploring both Lucas and Steven, don't get cute. Go run north to south, and we're going to do it. So this is a fourth down play here from the 45, and it's a big one. Looks like they're going to go for it. Patrick Harrigan under center. Actually, it's going to be Lucas under center on the shotgun. Lucas takes it. He kicks it. So nice sneak. No one there. It's a quick kick, and it's a good bounce for Reading. So let that thing bounce. It's going to get down to the 30-yard line. So Reading goes out a quick four and out, but they roll through a bunch of players early on, and that's one of the things that Coach Junta has to do with 33 guys on the roster. And that big Rocket defense is going to go in and these guys have seen this guy. They like to stack it up, Andy. A lot of guys, they don't know who gets the ball, but the Rockets did well last time against them, and here's their first series of downs. First and 10 from just over the 30-yard line. Familiar stack setup here. It's a keeper right up the middle. Oh, he gets hit. He's still on his feet. Barboza comes in now, too. He doesn't want to go down, number 24, but gets hit immediately by Lucas, and a bunch of guys take it. So, wow, that's a lot of people on him. Number 24 is a good player, but he didn't want to go down. A lot of guys hit him, but he got crunched that first one.
Probably the hottest 2 yards he's ever gotten.
I know. Lucas up the middle. That's a great spot, and I think they're leaving Lucas over the center this time. They split him out on that wide out the first game around. They're going to leave him in the middle. Second and call it eight here. Back to a traditional I formation here. Number 24 and 41 of the athletes. They'll call their name a lot today. Right here, number 24, he's got a hole. He cuts back, he's still on his feet, and he's gonna be gone. Let's see if he can be caught. He gets ripped down on the 1 yard line, and we just talked about it. Number 24 rips through it. Stephen Webb tries to come across and strip the ball out from him. He catches him. So huge play by Webb. We talked about that, but number 24, huge play. First and goal for Drakett. So big play. We just talked about him getting the ball. He's the guy they get a key on, and he breaks one for about 65 yards. First and goal upcoming. Handoff right up the middle, number 41. He drives it forward. He gets stacked up, and he doesn't make it. So nice job there. Danny Junter in there. Dan O'Connor in there pushing him back.
Beckenhuis as well.
Beckenhuis as well, and, of course, Lucas in there. So it's going to be second and goal. I can't see about here. It's probably about 3 yards out from where the pin is, so maybe four. Although, no, he moves it up now, so it's really about second and two here to get in the end zone. Not the start the Rockets wanted. This is a team that hasn't put up a lot of points against them, and they got a big, huge play early on here. It's a keeper up the middle. He gets stacked up. Number's 24. It's Lucas is in there, number 22. So they stuff him again. It's third down. Clearly, it's four down territory from here, but nice job. Nice job stopping him right here. Let's see how big that Stephen Webb play comes up here. He comes down and tries to hammer the ball out of there, and he takes him down. And it's now third down, and call it a yard. That's a tough call for this Rocket defense to hold him, but they just stopped him on the first two.
They're going to just have to put a wall up.
Look for number 41. He's a big guy. He's underneath right now. He might take it himself. He's moving guys over. Lucas is. Number 24 cuts back. He gets hit, but I think he's in, and he is in. So early on, Drakett. Huge play by number 24. He takes it in himself on the third down, and that's the guy you got to watch out for. And huge, huge play early on in the game. They hadn't seen inside the 30-yard line in game number one, but they come right down here and make a statement on the Rockets. And let's see if they're going to try to kick or they're going to try to go for one. They are set up to go for one in that traditional I formation. This was the formation, though. Number 24 broke a long one. It's a handoff. Oh, he's going to keep it himself. He's going to throw it. Oh, he gets stacked up beautifully. Nice job right there. Dan O'Connor was in there. So Danny Yoke comes in and makes a beautiful play on him. Nice job, and that's a huge play for Oakey right there. Like to call out my boy's name here and there. I like to hear it. So great play by Oak, and that one could come back to haunt him. So nice play by Drakett to come up early here, but Oakey makes a great play defensively and stops him when he's rolling out. But early on here with 4 minutes to go in the first quarter, we could never trust this clock, can we?
No, we cannot.
So we say it's 4 minutes. It is Drakett 6, Reading nothing. So there we go. Okay, Reading's going to get their second chance here. Down 6-0 early after one big play. This one's going to go over Webb's head. He's got to go back for it a ton. So Steven turns around now. He's looking for blockers. Cuts side to side, and he gets wrapped up immediately. So great kick. It's a fortunate bounce went over his head. It took a very tough bounce. Steven's not a small guy, and it drove him back inside the 20. And by the time he got there, there was a swarm on him. So here's the second series of downs for the Rockets. Let's see what they have in their bag of tricks.
16.
Okay, Lucas is back with Beckenhuis. Very tough bounce over Webb's head. It cost him about 20 yards up, and Sean Beckenhuis does a little bit of movement on it. It's going to move him back 5 yards to make it first and 15. So we'll do it again, first and 15 in the second. New offense in here, but the wind is whipping right in their face, at least as far as the flag indicates here. It's a direct snap to Damari, and Damari's got room. He cuts back. Nice job for Danny. He gets it back about 6 yards. So a nice run by Dan. It's nice to see him. I don't think he touched the ball all last game in that Lawrence game. So Danny is maybe one of our most natural runners there. And he knows how to hit a hole. And I think Bob Junta's seen enough of the dancing around. He's imploring some of the other running backs, don't dance, go north to south. And that's exactly what Damari delivers there. So he gets about 7 back. It's going to be second and 8 here. Nice run by Danny D. Troy and Dan, not the biggest two guys there. And Dan's going to keep it again. He goes outside. He's still on his feet, but he gets wrapped up. So nice job. That's a swarming defense for Draken. That's what's their, that's been their mantra all year. They've had a tough D all year. And he gets dropped for maybe a loss there. So it's going to be third and long upcoming. Now it's 30. Actually gained a yard there, Danny. We got Webb back deep with Troy in motion. It's going to be Sagala. It's a direct snap to Steven. Steven's going to get outside. He's got a little bit of room ahead of him. Steven, he gets cut down. Beautiful tackle right there. Let's see who had him. I'll tell you, there's one guy to beat, and it's their athlete, number 24. That's the best player on their team, no doubt about it. At least he was in the first game, and he's already shown it in this game. And he takes down Steven, and this is very, very tough field position. It's fourth and short, but you don't want to leave a short field with these guys and look for Lucas to come in and try to boot this one away. Tough win too, so any way you slice it, this is going to be good field position for Lucas to boot this thing. He does. It's a tough one. I told you that's a very tough win, and that's going to be luckily that's a Reading bounce, but I'll tell you, very, very tough. Net gain of about maybe 10 yards, kicked it up in the air, but we look at the flag right in front of us, Andy, and it is. That's a brutal, brutal win going in his face, and that's one that you might have want to go on a second guessing. It's easy for us to second guess with that win. You try it on fourth down and see if you get another four ticks on there, but it's going to be excellent field position for Drake. It taken over here, and it's first and 10 from inside the Reading 40. Okay, here we go. Is that familiar stacked offense here? Number 12 in the shotgun. It's a direct snap to him. He's got a nice hole there, and he cuts back. He gets hit hard by Beckenhuis, but he rolls off and spins for another 2 yards. So nice athletic play to get gain five or six. Beckenhuis came in strong, and he actually bounced him. So it might have been, let's call it second and five upcoming. Here we go. It's going to be second and five in the shotgun, number 12. It's right up the middle. He gets back. He gets wrapped up, but he spins for another one. He's shifty. He gets about 2 or 3 yards there, and it's going to be third and short upcoming.
Number 12 with the carry. It's going to bring up third down.
Here we go, third and short here in what is most obviously four down territory, so they're asking a lot out of the Rockets. It's stacked right. He's number 13, big number 13, takes it for the first down and more. Dante tries to rip the ball out, and then he gets pushed over. So that's the first time I think we've seen the big guy carry the ball into the first quarter right here, and I think they're going to turn this thing over for a first down here. So at least it is on the clock here. They're going to measure it with here, but the first down goes to Drake it, and Bob Junter is imploring his D to get fired up here. You guys are within 6 points here. You make a stop and we bring back the guns. Okay, here we go. It's going to be first and 10 here. Looks like around the 20-yard line. New series of downs here for Drake it. To keeper 24 is a good player. He gets wrapped up immediately and then gets stacked up. Nice play. That was Lucas who gets through as usual. Oki in there too. Danny O'Connor, he says. That guy's from Boston, huh? But 22, Damari was in there, so nice job. He stops him for no gain. This is where the Rocket D has to step up right here. They got the wind at their back in the second quarter. They'll have it at their back in the fourth.
Yep.
Haven't seen a lot of passes for these guys. They did do a couple of them that they executed well. Direct right to 24. He's got all sorts of room, and Danny Junta comes in, wraps him up, and then on top of him is Damari. So huge play by Junta. Threw out the big arms and stopped him. So keyed right on him, and he actually might have lost a yard there. It looks like he got one.
But great play by Dan right there. It's a big third down play, but we know it's four down territory. So a couple of big plays upcoming for the Rockets. All stacked up here. Under center is the big, not the big guy. He's just to the right. It's going to be direct snap to 24. He goes outside. He cuts up. Beautiful play. Still on his feet. Wow, he drives forward for another three or four. So very, very tough run, but he gets about five or six back, and it's going to be a huge fourth down, fourth and four upcoming. So huge play right here for the Rocket defense upcoming. All right, here we go. Fourth and a long four here. Huge play early on. The Rockets need to have a stop here. Number 12 is in the shotgun. It's direct snap to him. He cuts up, and he gets, oh, he's going to get pulled down
nice.
By Lucas, and
we needed that.
He doesn't get it. So the Rockets are going to take over here. Huge play by Lucas. Did he give him a first down? He gave him a first down. How did that happen? I don't see how that happened there in the first down. I didn't think he got that far. That was an easy 5 yards, and what a spot, and they give him the first down. Oh, that's a game-changing spot right there, Andy. You have to take a look at that one. It's very hard to see the lines out here. But hard to believe that that was a first down, and it was no question. Put his hands forward, and that's that. So Rockets are going to have to come up big right here. New four here for Drakett. Thought they had him there. Right up the middle, he gets crunched. Wow, the pushback by Lucas. He is furious right now. He drove the center right back into that guy, and he squeaks off for an extra one here. Second and call it 10 upcoming. Okay, here we go. Second and 10 here. More traditional backfield right here. It's going to be an inside handoff. Oh, almost gets him right there. He cuts up. He's still on his feet. So Lucas almost gets in there. Oki just misses him too, but in comes Webb. He does gain a couple. It's going to be third down, though. So nice little misdirection there too. And they almost had him in the backfield, but it's going to be third and call it 8. We go third and 8. I said, do we have a bad angle up here, or am I just a homer? Because that thing was unbelievable where that one went. This one looked to go right to 24. It does. He swings it right. He might get outside, too. He's got some speed. Dante Barboza comes in and closes, and so does Troy. So that's a big difference right there, is Barboza wasn't here in the first game, and he's got the speed to match 24. Comes right in, and Troy's got some sweet speed, too, and comes up and gang tackles him. So now it's 4th and 8 here, and this is a huge play for the Rockets. See if we can get the ball back here. He's out in the wing right now, so either going to pass or he's going to come cutting across. In motion. Here we go. It's a low one. He's going to try to pass this thing. He's wide open. Oh, what a play. Number 35 goes underneath, and he is absolutely wide open for the touchdown. Little miscommunication there, and it was set up perfectly, and they go in for the touchdown, and that's a killer. 4th and 8, and they convert not just for the first, but for the touchdown. And the Rockets right now chasing 12, maybe chasing 13 here with 4 minutes to go in the half. All right, here we go. Here's the extra point try. Last one was unsuccessful. This one's right up the gut to 24. Oh, Lucas
right
Fleming goes in and crushes him. So 24 versus 24, and Lucas says no, and that can come back as well. So these extra points have proven huge here, and now they're trying to implore these guys, saying, hey, guys, you got to get a cover one of these guys. So here we go. It's 12-0 Drakett. 4.5 minutes to go in the first half. We got plenty of time in this game, and the Rockets want to get some offense going now. Here we go. It's a nice kick there against the wind. This one's going to be fielded by Webb. Webb's going to cut left. He cuts up, and he has a little bit of room. Steven, nice job for a tackle there. Number 12, one of their good athletes at quarterback, cuts him down, but it's going to be 1st and 10 from the Rocket 44, and he is imploring the team, let's go, let's go. Troy Pollock goes in with the play, 1st and 10 for the Rockets. Like to get something going in this series here before the half. It's a keep, but it's inside handoff to Dante. He cuts left and right, makes another move there. He's still on his feet. Dante drives it for 6 or 7. He's a little bit shifty, Dante, but he's he gets out there and rips it off for about 6 or 7. And that's another guy, like you said, they haven't seen Barboza before, and he made a great play on D in the last series, and he makes a nice run here to start on first down. Okay, second and four here. Lucas Fleming back in there. Sean Beckenhuis too. Look for him to follow Sean. He does follow Sean. He cuts right behind him. That's a first down and more, and Lucas drives that for a first down down to the 40-yard line. That's a great play. I don't think Beckenhuis even had to hit anybody here, but that's a smart play by Lucas. He says, just follow your tough fullback. Beckenhuis rips it off for a big gainer. First and 10, and it's back to Fleming and Beckenhuis in the backfield. Stephen Webb split out. He follows him here. They get right in on him. Lucas this time, he's still on his feet. He just does not want to go down. And he drives that for probably three or four tough yards, maybe five. And nice start on first down. All right, here we go. It's second and call it seven right here. Direct snap. Lucas cuts outside. He just gets tripped up. Number 41 actually got thrown down, and he just tripped over him. So number 41 got thrown down on the ground, and it's going to be third and long. It's, wow, two-minute warning here, and the Rockets got to get something. They're fighting not just the down markers here, but they're going to fight the clock. Clear four-down territory under 2 minutes here. Troy Pollock in with the play. Webb swaps out for Dan Junta out on the wing. Under center is Troy. He's going to throw it, and he's got a guy all over him. Troy's got room. So he cuts back, gets outside, he's still out on his feet, so Troy gets a nice gainer there. He's gonna be a little bit short there, but he probably gets about seven or eight back, and it's gonna be fourth down here. Let's see where the spot is. Maybe they'll be as generous to us as they were to them last time, but it's fourth and four here, and this is a big play right here if the Rockets wanna get on the board. They will be kicking away in the second half. Big play here for the Rockets, call it fourth and five, and he sends Troy in with the play. They had an extra guy on the field, so. Okay, he had the wrong lineup out there, so they call timeout, and they're going to rethink this one. So that's the first one of the half, so they got a couple more to go here. So give Bob, Coach Bob a chance to rethink the fourth down play here. Very, very big play, fourth down here. Troy, number seven, under center, back is Dan Damari. Look for a pass here. He's going to keep it. He does. Oh, he's all over. They're all over him. He's got a guy. He's got to run. I don't know if he can do it here. And Troy gets run out of bounds, and they're going to turn the ball over. So they were all over him. He didn't have the chance for that play to set up. He was looking for Webb on a play that we saw against Lawrence, where there was just too much pressure on Troy, and they're going to turn the ball over here with under 2 minutes to go. And this is going to be a big test here. The Rockets need to keep these guys off the board here. Yeah, just go back. Here we go. First and 10 here. And there's plenty of time on the clock here for Drake to try to do something. They moved the ball well today. Misdirection here. Number four's got the ball. He gets pushed outside. He's got a whole hole right in front of him here. Last one left is Troy Pollock. In comes Barboza. He's still at his feet, and they drive him down. Huge run by number four. I haven't seen him pick up the ball all day today. And there was a hole you could drive a truck through over here, Andy.
Seriously.
So there was some good pursuit up at the very beginning. He rips it off for 40 yards. There's a timeout with a minute and 16 seconds to go. And the only win here for the Rockets is going to be keeping these guys off the board before the half. A couple of very big plays offensively for Drakett early in this game, at least in this first half. With a minute and 16 to go. Look for these guys. Maybe throw the ball here. We've seen a little bit of that. It goes right underneath. The ball almost fumbled. Big guy picks it up, drives it forward. That was almost a missed snap there, and he's just getting driven back. But, oof, that was a big opportunity for Redding. He almost muffed that ball, and it was loose. He did a good job to hold on to it, but it's going to be second and call it eight. Looks like there's another timeout here for Drakett. He goes second down here, that familiar stack formation for Drakett. Trying to trick guys who's going to get this ball. How they separated here. Inside handoff, number 12. He cuts up, gets strapped up immediately right there. Number, see, 51. Zach Kenyon is in there. And I'll tell you, these are the types of times where you might just say, with under a minute to go, they don't want to turn the ball over. That's all. They're up 12. They're getting the ball back. They're in a very good position. hold on to the ball, don't turn it over. Maybe give it a shot at the end zone, why not? Here we go, it goes to number 15. Oh, number 41 right there. He's gonna get stacked up immediately, crushed. The ball is on the ground, we get the ball. They got the ball here. Redding has the ball, hold on to it. Whoa, they nice. Have it. The ball's on the ground again. Redding takes the ball over here. There's only a handful of things there.
That was the play we needed.
Wow, we needed it, but we might run out of clock, but at least it's getting these guys fired up. Nice play by Dante. He loves to come in there and strip it himself, and I don't know if he was the guy who did it, but you know what? There's not a whole lot of time left on the clock to get on here, but let's get these guys fired up.
If they're fired up
enough, nice big
Webb
play right there.
Or Lucas.
Let's see if we send Troy in with a play, and they need some blocking up front to give Troy a little bit of time. You're gonna see these guys try to throw the ball, look for him to hit Webb. All right, here we go. We got Barboza split way right. We got Webb split left. Danny Damari and Troy in here. And he's got all sorts of time, but he's gotta get out of bounds. Get out of bounds, Troy. Get out of bounds. Wow, how much time is left? He takes it for about 30 yards. He gets out of bounds.
Something woke the Giant up.
Let's see, 7 seconds, they said. 7 seconds here. And if the Rockets could pull one out here and get on the board, it will change the entire face of the game. Huge athletic play by Troy.
7 seconds left and a half.
Coach imploring him over. They got another timeout here. First and 10 from about the 30-yard line. They're going to have to put the ball in the air maybe once, if not twice. But it's possible to get out of bounds and give another shot to the end zone. Here he has, they've been all over him up the middle, and he's had to make some athletic moves just to get out of there. We'll come back in a sec, see what they come up with. Maybe asking a lot here with 7 seconds to go, but look for Troy to put the ball in the air. They got a lot of guys out back. Troy's got guys all over him. He throws it out left and overthrows Barboza.
And a pass, incomplete.
We'll come back in a sec. Yep, 2 seconds left. This is going to be Hail Mary time here. He's got Barboza and Webb. He's going to tell him to get to the end zone. And there they go, and Troy's just going to fire it up in the air. He does fire it up and gets knocked down. So that's going to be the half here. Not a bad pass. We would like to see a little bit more bodies in there, maybe Barboza and Webb with a jump ball there. But nonetheless, at the half, a half that's been mostly dominated by Drakett, it is Drake at 12, Redding 0. Lucas Fleming set to kick off here in the second half. It's a low kick. He's going to field it. Yeah, number 12, good athlete, line. Gets it. He cuts up. He's still got room here, and he rips it back there. Gets pulled down. Still on his feet. He doesn't want to go down, but he gets it to about the 40. First and 10 for Drake at upcoming. Here we go, it's first and 10, the wind kicking up here. It's right in Drakett's face here. It's a little bit odd here. I thought we would have the wind in the fourth quarter, but looks like we have it in the third. Number 24 in motion, it's gonna be a handoff to him, and he almost gets hit by Oki, but he gets wrapped up immediately by Barboza. Oki busts through the line and almost gets him. Pushes him a little bit outside, and Dante comes in and closes. That's the type of speed they needed, so. Nice job there for Oki to get through, and then Barboza cleans him up. So it's going to be second and 10. Before in that QB, or at least in the backfield. Looks like number 12 is underneath there. Oki runs back over to get in position. It's a fake right up the middle. And they push it like it's a thing.
Up the middle, push it forward.
So that one's a fake in the background. He does push it for 3 or 4 yards. Take it down. Lucas and Danny Damari in there for the stop. So it's going to be third and call it 3 here. This is a tough one right here. This is going to be a big play because it's close to midfield. You may see them kick the ball away if we can put a stop on them. Right now, imploring that line to get through there on them. Number 15 in a QB right now. He's going to pitch out to number 24. He sees a hole. It's a big one. He gets closed on. Oh, he gets crunched early. Wow, nice job. He does. They do stop them.
Oh, that's an awful spot. He's giving it to him right on the line.
Oof, that is a tough spot. Very tough spot right there. Very tough spot. They gave it to him fourth and inches here. They were talking about pushing him back here. I think they stopped him a yard short of that.
Yep.
They gave him some real forward momentum. It's fourth and inches. You look for these guys to go for it. 50-yard line, though. I'm going to think they're going to go for this here.
Yep.
Try to keep another set of downs. This would be a huge stop for Reading. They put about nine guys across the line here. It's up the middle. He pushes it forward for the first down. So easy first down, the QB sneak. And they're going to take over. So that was a very, very tough spot. Not saying they wouldn't have gone for it with fourth and a yard,
sure.
But fourth and 6 inches makes it a little bit easier call. And so it's going to be another set of downs here for Drakett. And it is getting cold out here with the wind.
Oh, yeah, Andy, it is.
Huh? Whipping right at us here. The Reading flag is ripping right across us. We got to get this D fired up here and get the ball back for the offense. First and 10 here from about the 47-yard line. Handoff, it's going to be a reverse. Number four gets absolutely crushed by Lucas Fleming. A little bit of help by Oak, and that's all Fleming in there. Snuffs it out, so Fleming and Oakie get in there, and Fleming rips him down. Oakie whacks him in the back of the head for good measure, but it's a drop for about two yards. It's going to be second and 12 upcoming. Boring the rocket D. Nice pushback there. Number 12 under center, he's gonna hand it off right up the middle. Number 13, he gets stacked up immediately and crunch. He's still on his feet though, gets pushed back.
He's going back further.
Wow, nice play. Dante gets in there. 43, Lucas gets in there. And number 41, Beckenhuser's in there. So that's a big pushback right there. It's gonna be third and long upcoming. So nice job by the D there. This is the type of D that we've grown accustomed to, Andy. Let's see if we can get the ball back here, do something. Into this win. Although they scored on a pass earlier.
This way.
But the wind wasn't quite what it was right now. One guy back. He is going to go back to pass. He's got guys all over him. Right there,
Oki
gets high, and
him.
Lucas goes low, and they get him. So big pursuit. Keith Richmond and Danny Damari get in there as well. So all these guys get in there, and it was great play. Four guys in there, Richmond, Damari, O'Connor, and Fleming, and they push them way back. Fourth down, you're probably going to see them try to kick this one because this is, although the wind is tough, right? We talked about this. So the Rockets could get this ball back with good field position. Don't be afraid to see these guys go for it. If they think the wind's going to be too tough, why not give it a shot, right?
Well, they've got a 12-point cushion.
Yep. Number 12 is back a little bit farther, as if he is going to kick. Ooh, he does it straight in the air. Poison it. Oh, it gets a good bounce for
Drakett.
Fortunate bounce for Drakett. Could have went the other way, but out comes the Reading team now to take over first and 10 from the 35-yard line. Plenty of time left in the game here, and this is going to be a big series for the Rockets. Here we go, first and 10 for the Rockets here. From just inside their own 35, looks like Pollock under center. Lucas is back, he goes right up the gut. Lucas got a big first down, and Moore gets pulled down. Probably about six or seven to start. Nice tackle, but the guy who tackled him actually pulled Lucas on top of him, and he's hurt. So let's see how he is. He wrapped up Lucas, and Lucas fell right on top of him. That's a guy you do not want to fall on, and we'll come back in a second. Second and short here, number 12 is their quarterback, and he goes off gingerly as Lucas, he made a tackle on Lucas, unfortunately pulled him on top of him.
And nobody wants Lucas coming down on top.
No, I don't. You know? Troy Pollock under center. We get Steven Webb back deep. Let's see if we can get Steven's wheels in this game. Right up the gut to Steven. He cuts out left. He's got some room. There goes Webb. And he just gets pushed out. Nice job right there. Just pushes him out, but that's a great run by Steven, and that's the type of offense the Rockets need, and it stops the clock, so we'll take that too. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left here in the third quarter. Nice run by Webb, and that's what we need to see. He had one guy to beat, and he was just pushed out of bounds. So great run by Steven. We need a little bit more of that from the threes. Here we go, first and 10. Danny Damari back deep now. Troy Pollock under center. It's a handoff to Damari. He's got a big hole. He cuts back. Oh, he runs into his own guy, and Danny dives forward. So Dan takes that for a nice gain of about five or six. So ran in the back of his own player there, and almost breaks it himself. Danny's got great vision. Great vision to see that hole, and he's got great cutback ability. He's always going forward on his cutbacks. Lucas back in there, second and five. Look for him to follow Beckenhuyzen, and he does. Oh, they move in, but he's still on his feet. Lucas still on his feet. Oh, he's just bowling over people. Drives it for a first down. So that is a tough run right there by Lucas, and he's imposing his will on him right here. Love to see the Rockets finish this one off, and in comes the speed team with 33 back in.
They're almost doing a no huddle out here, running between Lucas, Danny, and Stephen Webb.
Here we go, first and 10 from the 30. Best series of offensive downs for the Rockets to start. Oh, it's going to be a keeper for Troy. He's going to follow Webb. He's following. He gets outside. Just gets pushed out. He probably gets about four or five. So that was a call play to follow Steven. I like to see Steven lower his shoulder on someone right there and make his presence felt. He's a big, fast, strong guy. He called it a gain of three, so second and seven upcoming. See a little bit more of Steven up the gut here, and that's exactly what we got. He cuts outside. Nice job by number 13 to string him out, and in comes 40. Number four puts a nice hit on him, so he does get a couple, but it's going to be third and call it five upcoming, maybe a long five. Big play here for the Rockets. Drake getting some players in last minute. We got Steven and we got Troy, and in motion is Sean Beckenhuyzen. It's a high snap to Troy. He pitches out to Steven. He's got some room and space. Steven gets outside. Great play by number 24, but he dives for it. Steven gets about three or four here, but there's that athlete, number 24, and he's very good. And he strings out Steven and catches up with him. But that was a good-looking play. He had one guy to beat, and I'd like to see Steve maybe cut that north to south instead of going outside. Number 24 looks like he has the speed that can probably catch him. But it's a fourth and four here. This is a huge play for the Rockets. Troy Pollock under center. Look for him to come Webb. And he does, but he's going to throw it out underneath. And he just, Jeremy Ross comes up with it. One-handed grab for Ross. Gets pulled out of the ground. What a beautiful play. I thought he let him too far from here. And Jeremy throws out the right hand and pulls it in. What a play by Ross. And we've been looking for him. You haven't called his number in the last couple of games. And he's a stupendous athlete. And what a play he makes there on a fourth down conversion. It's first and almost first and goal here, it looks like, from the 10. Beautiful play by Jeremy Rosh on a fourth down.
ESPN
awesome.
Top 10s right there.
Here we go. What a catch and what a throw by Troy. Let's see Lucas right here. He cuts back, he spins around, and they pile on him, but he gets a couple. So look for a little bit more of that, of Lucas right up the middle.
Bring up second and goal.
In comes Damari. Damari in, Fleming out, and Troy Pollock getting the play from coach. Second and goal. Looks like Lucas got just a couple there. Pollock and Damari. We may have a timeout call. End of the third quarter. Oof.
That went by quick.
It sure did. So the Rockets are pressing right here. It's second and goal. They love to get on the board here. Whole fourth quarter to go, but it's going to be some clock management that we need to deal with too. So we'll come back in a second. It's second and goal here. The sun coming out mercifully for us. It's going to be Damari following Pollock. He's got a hole, and Danny cuts in, takes a big hit, but he is down close to the goal line. Nice play by Dan right there, and it's going to be third and about a yard.
Damari with the carry, number 22. Third and goal.
Obviously four down territory here. They're going to send Lucas in. They're going to try to stack up Lucas. He's a guy that you're going to need the three guys to hit to stop him.
He's going to have a lot of momentum.
Third and a yard here. under center is Pollock. He hands right off to Lucas, and he puts his head down.
He's in.
Nice job with Lucas right there, untouched. So the Rockets go in, and you probably see them try for one here because they've had some haven't had luck with kicks, but they also have the wind right in their face, and this could prove to be a huge extra point right here. So 9 minutes to go in the game, fourth quarter just starting, and this extra point is going to be a big one. Troy Pollock, he is going to Pollock almost exclusively here in the second half.
Yep.
And he might be one of the smartest players on the team, too. So great football sense and a good athlete. Look for Lucas to follow Sean Beckenhuis. And that's what he does. He follows, and he's in.
He's in.
Beautiful play. Back-to-back Lucas Fleming. That's a huge play, and Coach Junta's fired up right now. Fired up. That extra point's huge, and we talked about it earlier. Let's talk about that early extra point that Danny O'Connor snuffs out the first one. Lucas Fleming snucks out the second one, and those plays may end up coming back huge here for the Rockets. So with plenty of time to go here, it is Drake at 12, the Rockets 7. Rockets. Going to be a big play here for these guys here. The defense is going to have to come up here and get the ball back for the Rockets. It's a nice kick right there, low. He fields it. No, 41, he's on the ground there. Gets kick crushed immediately. Oh, he's still on his feet, though. Nice job, though, by Bozy and Quick.
Running down there quickly to cover. Webb, number 33, also down.
Nice job, so good job there.
Dante Barboza.
And we'll see first and 10 upcoming. Sorry. All right, this is gonna be a big series for the Rocket D right here. First and 10, they had a great job in the last series. They go back to their familiar stacked up offense here, like who's gonna get the ball. They keep it themselves, he pushes forward, he's on his feet, he's still on his feet, takes it for about 5 or 6 yards. So a little bit of trickery that we saw when we first ran this team, but it's been effective. Here we go, call it second and a long four here for Draken. This one gets snapped out here. He's got a hole here. That's a runner. He's got room in front of him, and he's got a hole. He's still on his feet. One guy left, and he's going to go. Steven Webb is going to do it again. Webb jumps on him. He pulls him down again, just like the first play, and number 24 rips off a massive play for Drake it right here. Beautiful play there. Webb does a touchdown saving tackle, but that is a play that is going to be a killer. 260 plus yard runs for their athlete number 24. It's no secret they're going to give him the ball, and he makes huge athletic plays right there. And the Rockets first and goal from about the 1 foot line. Very, very difficult series here as Drake it answers and answers very quickly. It's a keeper right there, and I think he may be in, I'm not sure.
Drake it, second and goal.
Need a big stop here.
An almost insurmountable task for the Rockets on the 1 foot line here. Keeps it, pushes right up the middle, and it looks like they get in. So they get in. Drake it gets in. That's a huge answer right there for against the Rockets. It's going to make it 18-7 right now. We'll see what the extra point brings here, but I'll tell you what, a quick strike answer for Drake it, and that number 24 is some player. And he made a bunch of guys miss, you know, top defense for the Rockets. And he's ripped off a couple of monsters against them, which have killed so far today. Extra point try here. Looks like number 12 is no longer in there. That's the guy who took the hit. That's their starting quarterback. Goes right to 41 up the gut, and he drives it in. And I don't know if he gets it. He's still pushing. And they do not give it to him. So they stop him, great job. So hey, they've stopped all three. Right now it's 18-7 with 6:50 left in the game, and the Rockets are gonna need some quick strike offense of their own to get back in this one. He might be a little bit even better, quicker athlete. Nice boot back there, it goes back to Barboza. Dante looking for a block. He follows Steve. He's got a hole, and Dante gets outside. Oh, has one guy to beat, and who gets him? Number 24, of course. He's a one-man gang out there. Tell you, the whole different team. He's making tackles. He's running for 60 yards, and he saved game touchdown-saving tackle on Barboza there. So great field position over midfield. Great run back. And the Rockets need to do something and do something quick here. It's 5 minutes, 6 minutes and 37 seconds. There's still plenty of time, but we need to move down the field and do it quickly. First and 10 here for the Rockets. We got Barboza and Webb split deep. Look for Troy to put this one in the air. He is. He throws it out to Steven. Steven makes a catch, makes one move. He's got to go outside. Hold on to the ball. Nice job. So good play. He gains about 6 or 7. Steven had one guy to beat, credit number 33 for Drake it to come in and stay with him. And good looking play to start on first down. Quarterback. Jeremy Rosh back in the game. He made a big catch earlier. Steven Webb split left as well as Barboza. Back deep is Damari. Oh, the ball's on the ground. It's fumbled.
Oh, I think Troy got on it.
Wow, the Rockets. Troy gets back in there and gets the ball. That one could have been all she wrote for the Rockets if that turned over, but Troy does a nice job to stay on it. He's going to say do the same play. It's third and five here. Clear four down territory this late in the game. Down two scores. It's a push to Danny, and Danny's going to flip this to Steven. He goes way wide. He's going to cut up. Oh, boy. Gets tackled. Number 24 trips him up again. Number 53 in there as well. Steven went a little wide back there. He had a bunch of stuff to gain, bunch of ground to make up. And it's going to be fourth and five here. And this is a play that the Rockets have to have. Two scores. This play could effectively be the game, Andy. So this is a big one. Troy under center. Split left Barboza. Behind him is Damari. Steven Webb out on the wing. Troy putting Danny on his opposite side. He's going to throw it out to Steven. Wasn't the best pass. Number 33 was right on Steven Webb. They tried the similar pass, and the Rockets are going to turn the ball over here. So a little bit of a wobbly pass out there. I don't know if it would have, even if it was on target, number 33 was all over and might have snuffed that play out. So Drakeet is going to take over first and 10 here, and you're going to see up two scores. You got to think that they're going to ground and pound this thing and try to take all the sorts of time off the clock. The Rockets are going to have to get opportunistic here. They're going to have to get in there and try to strip that ball away.
Here you go.
First and 10 here for Drakeet. It's a keeper for 24. He gets outside, and there's one guy to beat. It's Troy. He shakes him. Barboza comes in. He's on his feet, and he's gone. Jeremy Rosh is going to try to catch him. He goes in. One-man show. Number 24 can't be brought down by the Rockets' top athletes, and that guy is one heck of a player, and he has run roughshod all over the Reading Rockets today. Cannot be stopped. They don't have an answer for him. Number 24 goes in for his third touchdown of 60 yards plus or more, and they don't have an answer for him. And that's going to be the nail in the coffin here with 4 minutes to go. You go up 24-7. We'd have to have some very, very fortunate bounces to get back in this one. So here we go for the extra point. It's going to be a pass here, throws it up there, and he brings it. He brings it in, makes a pass, beautiful play, beautifully set up play, throws it over the Rocket defenders, and they score. So it's going to be 25-7 with 4 minutes to go. And I'll tell you, the quick strike offense, in particular, number 24, he has been what a player. Best player on the field by far today, and he looks like a man among boys out there. We'll be back for the kickoff. Drake it to kick off, and it's a nice boot there. It's going to go to Steven. He drops the ball, but he picks it up. Steven starts up. He's telling him, puts his head down, gets wrapped up by number 87, makes the tackle. Steven dives forward over just about to the 35-yard line. Rockets are going to take over. There's 4 minutes to go in the game. They need now what is three scores to get back in this game, and that might be too tough a task with not a lot of time on the clock here. But nonetheless, what a great year for these guys anyway. Great season. You know, and I tell you, this was a game where the number of players on the team had a huge effect early because, plain and simple, the Pop Warner rules say everyone has to play a certain amount of plays, and it's very difficult when you got a team that has 22 players and one that has 34 or 32-plus to manage that game clock, and no one's done it better than Coach Junter and his staff this year. This Steven on the inside handoff, he cuts up, and he dives forward for about six or seven.
Going to bring up second out.
Like to see Steven run a little more north to south, just like that last one. We got Troy and Steven in the backfield here. This one goes back to Troy. Troy's going to throw it. Oh, he pulls it back and throws it out. It is a complete pass. Jeremy Rosh is still on his feet, and he gets pulled down from behind. So Rosh makes another beautiful catch. Gets pulled down by big number 13. So Jerry makes another beautiful catch. Troy, who had to pull it down, and then he re-cocked the arm and sent it out to Jeremy. Makes a beautiful catch. Gets over midfield for first down. Okay, first and 10 here after the great passing catch by Pollock and Rosh. Back to Pollock again. He throws it underneath. Oh, boy, gets tipped a couple of times. And that one almost gets tipped. He's going to Jeremy again, but they had a couple of defenders back there, and that one gets tipped. And here we go with 2:52 left in the game. The Rockets are trailing by a bunch here. The incomplete pass will stop the ball, but we're still right at midfield, second and 10. Okay, second and 10 here. Goes back to Troy. Troy's got to keep it. He's got guys all over him. He keeps it himself. He tries to shed a guy. He's still on his feet. Troy can get out of bounds. He gets pulled out of bounds. Maybe a little extracurricular there, but what a great play. And Troy rips that thing off for about almost 30 yards, 27 yards for a first down. And, I'm looking at the 20, probably a 22-yard run there for a first down. Great run by Troy. He stops the clock with 2 minutes and 39 seconds to go here. Rockets going to need a little magic. So it goes directly to Troy. He throws underneath him. Dante's there. Oh, just misses it. Dante was open. It was a good pass. Dante lays out for it, and he just misses it. Just led him a little bit too far. So good-looking play. Both Damari and Barboza are out there. Call it second and 10 upcoming. Here we go, second and 10 right now. Webb and Pollock in the shotgun. This one's going to go to Troy. He's going to fire it underneath. He fires it deep. Ooh. Barboza cuts in. It was a little bit out. Looked like it was going to be a little bit more of a post pattern there. And that one falls incomplete. It's going to be third and 10 upcoming. He can, unfortunately, with third and 10 here. Steven and Troy here. Goes back to Troy. He's got guys all over him. Throws underneath to Dante. And Dante hits the chest and hits him and makes a nice play. Number nine breaks it up. He had Barboza short, certainly wasn't going to be near the first down, but bounced off the pads, and it's going to be fourth down here for the Rockets. 2 minutes approaching. See if they get another first down in their playbook here for the boys. Troy goes back to pass. He throws it underneath to Dante. Dante makes an athletic catch this time, and he's close to the first, but I don't think he gets it. And they're going to turn that thing over on down. So Drake is going to take over first and 10 with the game in hand here. And I'll tell you what a difference it is. It looks like they knocked out their starting quarterback. The number 12 has been out since Lucas rolled on top of him. And this was a game, Andy, that it seemed like the Rockets at the first half came out a little bit flat, you know, and very quiet out there. Big early strike. But to be honest with you, today might not have been their day, because it was certainly the day for Draken, and in particular number 24, who just had his way out here today. Three massive touchdowns, making plays all over the field. He's back there again, and the Rockets are going to see 24 in their nightmares in the offseason. But I'll tell you what, no matter what happens here, it's going to be a reverse right here to number four. He gets wrapped up immediately by Keith Richmond, 21 in there, snuffs it out. And you're probably going to see these guys start to run the clock down and low. Looks like a timeout here for the Rockets to stop the clock. But I tell you, what a great year.
Great year for these guys. They played very, very well. They won two playoff games. They came in here to a team that they felt confident that they could do well against. They lost 7-6, put the ball on the ground three times in that first game. But I'll tell you, they ran into something today they just couldn't deal with. And the Rockets are going to wrap up a great season here today. But nonetheless, awful lot to be proud of with this team. A lot of players on the team. Very difficult to manage that. And coach getting in a couple of other players here late in the game. Oh, the ball's on the ground. It's filling the ground. The Rockets dive in there. I think Matt Sagala might have that ball. He was kicking it around there, number 13. That's the second time he put the ball on the ground, the big guy. I don't know if he's had his hands on the ball that often. But the clock ticks down to under a minute and a half here. And just a matter of time here at the end. Andy, I want to thank you for stepping in late. You stepped in who can we think about? Like Tom Brady for Drew Bledsoe, right?
There you go. That's a comparison.
You came in. I mean, as we know, Drew Bledsoe is very much BVH, right?
Yeah.
And so you came in and taken over, and frankly, no one is talking about Bledsoe or BVH anymore.
Once they see all about
your
it.
Camera prowess has been outstanding. By the way, another guy I wanted to mention. I know when your last game is a loss and you're playing the playoffs, we had a lot of fun here this year and get to act like we're 10 years old, which is great. But speaking of acting like 10 years old, inside hand up, it's a keeper for 15. He's got all sorts of room in front of him. Here comes Andrew Fortino right here, your boy, and he's going to push him out. Nice play by Andrew right there. But talking about 10-year-old boys, how about Coach Dan DeMari at the end of last playoff game? He was dancing around. He said he looked like Jimmy Valvano looking for someone to hug on the basketball court after they won it all. So he was. What a treat to watch DeMari out there. And want to say thanks to the coaching staff, including DeMari, Adam Pollock, Mike Masucci, Dan Beckenhuis, Dan Webb, and, of course, Coach Bob Junta. Want to say thanks to Mandy Harrigan right over here, our photographer, Joe Dwyer, that maybe the toughest one in all the sports, keeping minimum plays for this team. You need to be a math major to do that. And Paul DeRoss and all sorts of other guys. So great game, great win here for Drake to move on. They're an excellent team, have some very good players. Today wasn't the Rockets' day, and the season wraps up here. And we'll say thanks again to everybody. Thank you to RCTV, Luke and Angela. They are the ones who get out all the stuff and do the stuff for our coaches. They were awesome all year, and they're part of the reason why Reading is one of the best programs around. And we will see you again. We'll wrap it up for the season for the B-Rockets. They lasted the longest, got through three playoff games, and they come up a little bit short here on the EMAS final. So, Andy, thanks again. We'll see you next year.